is the lineup on the inside. Clement of Scotland, Bayi, Tanzania, Craig of Canada, Wagwar of Kenya, Glenn Grant of Wales, Moorcroft, then Koskai, then Big Rod Dixon, QI, Hutchings of England, McGuinness of Northern Ireland, and John Robson of Scotland. 3 3/4 laps of the track. And straight away, the pace being set by Filbert Bayi, tracked by one of the Kenyans, Paul Craig of Canada next, and Robson of Scotland just behind. Rob Dixon back in fifth place, and the two Englishmen are just two places from the back. Filbert Bayi putting a statement of intent out immediately. Koskai in second place, number 260 looking round. And right at the back at the moment, as usual, Wagwar of Kenya, who starts slow and finishes fast. Coming round with three laps to go, Bayi leads, Koskai second, Craig is third. In fourth place is Chuai. Fifth is Robson, sixth is Dixon, seventh McGuinness, eighth Clement, ninth is Moorcroft, and in tenth place Hutchins, with Glenn Grant 11th. And Wagwar, one of the favourites, unbelievably lets them get away like this, prefers to do his running late. But what a gamble to take against Bayi, who's gone through now in 57.67 seconds at 400 metres. Much slower than when he set the world record, but he kicks hard down the back straight, and there's now 20 metres between the leader, Bayi, and the second favourite, Wagwar, right at the back. The two Kenyans chasing, QI and Koskai. Then John Robson, this promising Scot who's developed throughout the season in fourth place. Dave Moorcroft moving up to challenge slowly, almost imperceptibly, back in fifth place. But in the right place, Clement moving up too. Moorcroft doesn't get trapped on that curb though at this stage. Clement moving through on the outside with Moorcroft, and Moorcroft realizes there he's got a problem. A gap beginning to develop, but it gives him space to come out. Two laps to go, Bayi leads. In second place, Chuai. Third is Robson moving up inside Koskai. And still Wagwar at the back has made no move. Tailed off Tim Hutchings of England as they come round now to complete two laps and 800 meters. The time then, 1:55, as opposed to his 1:52 when he set the world record. Bayi still in front. In second place, cruising is Chuai of Kenya. Then Robson of Scotland, Moorcroft of England, Clement of Scotland in fifth place. Going up on the inside in sixth is Glenn Grant of Wales. Seventh is Rod Dixon. And still no move from Wagwar from the back. Just tracking Paul Craig, and he's leaving himself so much to do. Well, you've got to be a lot better than the rest if you can win from that position. But gradually he's coming through on the outside. Wagwar, 2:83. There he is, running wide. And this time, the sound of the bell. Just over 400 metres to go. The champion and world record held in front. Robson of Scotland, the perfect race, giving himself every chance second. Moorcroft of England is third. Grant of Wales, four. And Clement of Scotland, five. At the moment, four UK athletes in the first five. And still Wagwar is sitting back in sixth place and gradually closing. Bayi of Tanzania leads. Robson of Scotland, second. Moorcroft of England, third. Grant of Wales next. Clement is next. And here comes Wagwar with that supercharged late run. 200 metres for the leader. The record holder leads and champion, Bayi of Tanzania. Robson digging it in second place where he's been all the time. Moorcroft third, and they're stretching away. Wagwar has no hope of catching them. Fourth is Clement, fifth is Grant, but these should be the three medalists. Moorcroft on the outside for England, Robson for Scotland, Bayi Tanzania, and it's Dave Moorcroft on the near side. Moorcroft for England. Will he get the gold medal? Yes is the answer. Bayi second, Robson third, Clement fourth. And within the space of 15 minutes, England have taken both the gold medals in the 1500 metre races. A perfect waiting race by Dave Moorcroft of Coventry Godiva. Talked to him the other night. He said he was going well. He's timed his preparation perfectly. And he just took Bayi when Bayi was beginning to suffer. The three medalists were getting away here. An appallingly bad race by Wagwar, the second favourite. Bayi ran his usual race from the front. If you can stay with him, he's vulnerable. And the question is whether Robson was caught on the line or not. It's very, very close. Now, there's Bayi on the inside. Moorcroft with a clear run, driving for home. The hard work he's put in the past 2 years when he's been living in New Zealand, paying off. And this is the strength of a man who has also finished second in the National Cross Country Championship. The tape's in sight. The gold medal belongs to Dave Moorcroft.